Hey there! So today we have another review, and this is a beer courtesy of Jeff who stopped by the brewery. This is Sour Manjaro from Deviant Wolf in Sanford, Florida. So Sanford, Florida is an interesting town. It's about 20-30 minutes north of downtown Orlando. And outside of downtown Orlando, there's pretty much nothing to do around in this area. So it's actually got a proper downtown. And for a town of 60,000 people, it's got so much going on. It's got four breweries, which is really high per capita. It's got a proper cocktail bar. It's got a proper speakeasy tiki bar. It's got a German beer hall, beer garden kind of thing. It's got a craft beer garden. It's got, it's got all kinds of stuff. It's got dive bars. It's got, having worked there and lived there, it's got all kinds of stuff. The downtown's absolutely insane within a, it's less than a mile radius. It's just like that downtown, just like jam-packed, super fun. Highly recommend it if you ever do visit Orlando. Spend a killer night in Sanford. So Deviant Wolf is one of the four breweries in Sanford, and actually some close friends are actually opening up a brewery there. So it'll be five breweries, absolutely insane. So Deviant Wolf's relatively new. I wanna say they're about 2 years new. And crazy enough, this is their Sour Manjaro, a coffee sour blonde. And fun beer, but having visited there, 5.1%, they said apparently this is one of the most popular beers. That's absolutely crazy that a sour, a coffee kettle sour is one of the most popular beers for a Florida town craft brewery. Hey, guess what? Pretty interesting times we live in. So the beer comes in a beautiful kind of like medium gold color, medium deep gold. It has like this kind of viscosity to it where the carbonation is riding on this one, almost like if there's like, you know what it is? The beer might have a decently high residual gravity to it, or final gravity to it, because it just like seems like it's a bigger beer at 5%, but wonderful fluffy white head on the nose. I miss this coffee for days. I mean, it smells like blonde coffee beer. It doesn't necessarily have the big, rich, deep coffee roast or chocolate like a stout, but it almost comes off like that. It's actually a very pretty coffee aroma. It's freshly ground, delicious artisanal coffee. Like it really smells like a, it actually really very much smells like when you go into a very nice coffee place. Yeah, it really smells fantastic. Whatever they're using source of coffee or how they're getting the coffee into there, it just has this really like non-intensely acrid, roasty. It's just like bright, delicious, kind of like, you know, cracked coffee beans. On the palate, it's so strange. This is a bright, acidic kettle sour. It's decently sour, actually. And then, I don't know, like, it's actually not a sweet beer. Very confusing. Maybe it's just like visually appearance, like just making stuff up, but the beer is decently acidic. pH for me, if you guys like ever rock into that, it's probably around 3.1, 3.2. Decently acidic beer. Yeah, so strange because the aromatic is so coffee forward. And obviously that comes in on the palate, but the acidity is so bright that like your palate sort of like, the flavor of coffee sort of lost because your tongue is biting at that acidity. But the coffee is so delicious that it's like, beautifully melds it into the beer. And then as you wait, there's almost like a nutty tone to it. It's almost like macadamia, nice toastiness, and like almost a light vanilla note. And then like, it's just a, it's a bright kettle sour, but then the richness of the delicious coffee flavor offers nutty and almost sweet tones, even though this beer has no sweetness at, with it at all. Yeah, it's really, man. So what they've really crushed on this one is just integrating really great coffee flavors. And if they've done it such a good job, I feel like this could be a brewery. I mean, granted, I haven't been to this brewery in a long time, but I feel like this brewery would crush being able to integrate coffee into, hell, IPAs, do blonde stouts, do pastry stouts and all this kind of flavor. I think the coffee is just like one of the most elegant and delectable ways that coffee has been introduced to a non-traditional beer recently that I've had. And then it's just sitting underneath a pretty kind of kettle sour. It's a fun one. It's a very fun one. Honestly, it tastes very commercial too, which is great for a local small craft brewery that's only like 2 years young, that, you know, has no distribution footprints. It really tastes like a beer that could be produced by one of the bigger breweries. You know, it could be a Stone beer or a left-hand beer or New Belgium. You know, like, it just has a precision to it. The kettle sour is just beautifully cut and executed. The coffee flavors, really, if anything, maybe even artisanal in my mind. So smaller craft brewery, but really well executed. This beer for me gets a proper 90. It's impression. It's a fun impression beer. 93. Sour Manjaro from Deviant Wolf. Also in town, in my opinion, probably the best craft brewery in town, making the best beer in Sanford. So check them out. Until next time, guys. Cheers. Later.